You've got to really, there are a lot, there's a lot he needs to learn about sodas.
These ain't the sodas, this is just a bottle.
Well, that's the point of the glass bottle. I mean, you can't just do that with any bottle. You probably can't do that with the plastic ones. You certainly can't do that with a can.
At
That's one of the
all.
cool things about a bottle. So we promised you a few things in our last video. One was we promised we'll tell you the double cola 1933. So it's been around a long time. Long, long time. And yeah. And am I sure? Yeah, I'm pretty sure that says
Okay.
double cola on it. Now the IBC is older than that. Did you know that IBC stands for?
Idaho bumping carrots.
No, Idaho does potatoes, so that
Oh,
wouldn't.
okay. What's a synonym?
Indianapolis, maybe? Or no. No,
Indianapolis bouncing
no,
carrots.
it's not Indiana either.
Okay.
But you're getting but it's closer. You're getting it's Iowa Bottling Company.
It's
Iowa
on
Bottling.
the tip of my
Yeah.
tongue.
It's been around since 1990. Now, I don't know if they've made this cherry limeade that long, but the company
I don't
itself has
know.
been
I
around that
think
long.
the cherry limeade is fairly new,
Yeah.
actually. I'm not
Yeah.
sure on that though.
But one of the granddaddies of them all, and certainly the most famous soda brand in the world, is you probably recognize the shape of the
Oh
bottle
yeah.
even without seeing the name. Are you going to show them the name, or
No, no.
they just have to guess
Now,
from the
I will tell you,
this particular one hadn't been around that long.
no, this is a special one. This is one of their new ones. This is Coca-Cola California Raspberry.
Yeah. Now Coca-Cola has been around since 1886. This has been around what, a couple of months? I
Yeah,
mean, it's pretty
something
new.
like
It's
that. Something like
so.
that.
And we really wanted to get the Georgia Peach one, which it seems how it was made in Atlanta originally. Dr. Pemberton made the Coca-Cola in Atlanta and Georgia Peach. I mean, you would think that they would stock that in our local grocery store. And there is a spot for it on the shelves, as we're in Georgia. You'd expect Georgia.
Okay,
They,
well,
I think they underestimated how popular
it would be
Georgia
in
Peach would be in
Georgia.
Georgia. I
Yeah,
mean,
maybe.
I don't
Yeah.
know. But we're going to try to find one of those. Although, if it's as disappointing as this one, well, okay. It's Coke. We've already told you. We're not fans of Coke. It's one of our least favorite of the colas. I cannot imagine why it's the most popular cola in the world.
Okay, yeah, considering how much everybody in this world loves sweet stuff.
Well, not everybody. Only in America. I mean, other
That's
countries,
true.
they're
But I
not. Maybe
mean,
that's why they
even
like it
in
better.
America,
Yeah.
this is a big soda.
I mean, like, have you ever been? You haven't been to the Coca-Cola. We've got to go to.
I went to the one at Epcot.
Yeah, we did the
Epcot.
tasting thing. Oh, they had. Oh, some of the stuff they drink in Europe that Coca-Cola makes. I mean, it tastes like Alka-Seltzer. It's really. Oh, it's. I mean, not the flavored Alka-Seltzer either. Just
No,
like the plain.
no.
Ugh. It's a. Oh, it's
It tastes
atrocious.
almost worse
And
than that.
it's like their most popular things over
And
there in Italy and
you know what
France and
was
stuff.
really sad? While we were there at Epcot trying all the different Coca-Cola flavored sodas, by the way, they had a kiwi mango cola something that was actually it was pretty good.
Yeah,
It was fruity and it was
they had
good.
a few that were
But
good.
the one that tasted like Alka-Seltzer, I tried it just to try a bit and see how bad it was. And so I barely got a sip and I couldn't stand it, so I just tossed the rest. And then after me, this guy comes up, he gets a whole little the little shot cup things they've got
Yeah,
there.
little Dixie
He
cup thing,
drinks
yeah.
the whole thing, he goes,
Oh, that's good. I'll
and
get
he
some
gets
more of
another one. I'm
that.
like,
Yeah.
what is wrong with you? No.
Okay, so we also promised you a couple other things. We've got,
What were they?
well, one was how to cool your sodas.
That is
I mean,
true.
obviously you can stick them in the refrigerator, but what if you're in a hurry? What
Hey,
if you bought it and you've got to cool it off in a hurry and you can't let it sit for hours in the
if
fridge
you
before
wanna
it's cold?
have fun, you get you a
And you've got
glass,
some money to blow.
you get a glass bottle soda, and you stick it in the freezer.
Yeah, don't leave it too long.
Well,
About 20 minutes, 20 to 25 minutes max,
if
or you
you
can wind up
wanna
busting.
have fun,
If you
you
want
will leave it long.
somebody to have to clean up a mess, you'll leave it longer. You know, that's the way that works. No, but what was your favorite way of cooling them off quickly?
My favorite way of cooling off a soda quickly is a fire extinguisher.
That will do it.
Yeah.
Mythbusters tested that one. I mean, it got it down in just a matter of like 30 seconds.
It's also crazy expensive. Of course, you got to clean it up. I mean, even the small fire extinguishers
are expensive. I have 40, 50 bucks at least. I mean, you know, it's a fast way to cool them off. I guess if it was an emergency and you were going to die without a cold soda.
Like, I need a soda. Yeah.
But realistically, though, it's going to take a long time in the refrigerator. And in the freezer, even, it's going to take 20 to 25 minutes to get it down cold to drink. But if you put it, like, actually in some ice, that'll speed it up. If you actually put some water in that ice and make it ice water and stick the soda down in that, that'll speed it up even more. And you can get it in about 7 minutes, 6-7 minutes. But if you actually put salt water and ice and mix them and then put your soda in it, you can have a cold soda in about 2 to 2 minutes, 2.5 to 3 minutes.
Wow,
something like that.
Wow. What about dry ice?
You know, I don't know, because dry ice, it evaporates, so it's kind of hard. And you do not want to pour your soda over dry ice. Remember we did that one time at a birthday party? We had like the punch and the dry ice, and it looks really cool. But it dry ice makes it taste nasty. Oh, yeah. So you don't want to do that. But, yeah, the ice water, the salt ice water. Now, you'll want to wipe it off unless you really like that salty taste with your sodas, I guess.
Well, some sodas might be good with a little kind of salt taste.
Well, like I know this one needed something. Maybe salt would have helped. Let's put it this way. My wife rarely eats sugar. She's like, you know, she exercises, teaches classes at the gym, eats right, unlike me. And, you know, so she doesn't even eat sugar. But we got this for her special treat. Oh, it's the raspberry one. She thought it needed to be sweeter.
And she stays away from sugar.
The person who doesn't like sweet thing, doesn't eat sweet things, this needs to be sweeter. So
basically, something. As far as
it's Coke,
as far as California raspberry Coca-Cola is concerned, it's Coke with just a tiny hint of raspberry flavor.
Yeah, hint might be the right word.
I'm not sure if hint's enough. Minuscule smidgen.
And instead of raspberry flavored Coca-Cola, they should have probably called it Coca-Cola. That's about all of the raspberry there was.
I'm not sure that would have gotten the message across, though. They should have called
this
it.
This didn't get the
they
message
should have
across.
Called it Coca-Cola.
No, then people would have really thought it would taste like raspberry.
Ah, that's true. That's true. Okay.
I don't know. It can't be much. Okay, now the other thing that we did promise, though, was we want to help you have a better day. So, a merry heart does good like a medicine. That's what the Bible says. So we want to share something with you that we found out about. Was it about math teachers or just teachers in general?
I think it's just teachers in general.
But it's a math problem.
I figure
problem.
It would apply to anybody.
But it was a math question.
Yeah, it was.
That came up. And so the question is, what was the math question? It was something.
Okay, so the question, it was,
if your
math teacher has two bottles in one hand
and three in the other,
what does he have?
And the answer is a drinking problem.
Yeah, so if he's got three bottles in one hand and two in the other,
yeah, that's
he's got a drinking problem.
Yeah. But there was another question.
There was a follow-up question to that, and it went, if he's got five bottles in one hand, seven bottles in the other, then what does he have?
Really big hands.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, that's,
there you go.
Wow. I mean,
he's also got a pretty big bladder, too, if he drank all of those.
Well,
because, yeah, I mean,
strong one.
Yeah.
Or he's been in the bathroom a lot.
One of those.
Yeah, we were buying, so, I mean, two in each hand is pretty tough.
Yeah.
When we're getting them and putting them in to buy.
Because you can kind of stick them, the necks in between your fingers here.
I mean, then they start banging together. And,
yeah. And there's a couple times where I'd grab a couple and be afraid I was about to drop one or something.
Ah. Still got to work on that.
It's hard to hit it, like, right when you get right up there.
It's just like that. It's not that hard. I don't know. It's my only musical talent right there. That's it. That's the only instrument I can play.
But I can actually whistle.
I can whistle. Why do you need to whistle?
You always told me you couldn't whistle.
I can't. I can't whistle very well. I can only whistle when I'm sucking air in. Okay, we're way past the Coca-Cola.
We are.
And it won't wet your whistle very well unless you
goodbye,
just...
Goodbye,
I guess Coca-Cola. If you like Coca-Cola...
Yeah, if you like Coca-Cola...
I mean, a hint of raspberry could...
You... This Coca-Cola raspberry might make your day.
Yeah.
For us, it was... But, as far as your day goes, enjoy, and we'll see you next time.